Made in Hollywood.
Based on the best-selling novel, the arrival of a mysterious package gives a struggling bookstore owner a new lease on life as Lucy Hale and Christina Hendricks star in the storied life of A.J. Fickrey.
I'm Amelia.
I work for Nightly Press. This one is my favorite. It is a book about the possibility of finding great love at any age. Don't you just love that?
This is not for me.
No problem.
I play a book sales rep, and I bring together these lists. I recommend The Late Bloomer, which AJ rejects, then reads years later, falls in love with it. And that is sort of what brings us together, is this story.
Why don't you tell me something about your lifestyle?
I'm 39 years old. I live alone. I subsist on a diet of frozen entrees. I'm not what you'd call an alcoholic, but I like to drink until I pass out at least once a week. And since my wife died, I hate my work.
I'll start with exercise.
Okay.
Grief and loss will do very strange things to people. And obviously it has nothing to do with books. I mean, he's lost the love of his life. And because of that, he's lost the will to live.
He was married to my sister. So I feel a great sense of responsibility of making sure he's okay and that he's being fed and that he's getting up in the morning, which is proving to be harder and harder and harder.
Who the hell are you?
Maya.
The mystery sort of present or gift or package that is left in the bookstore is this baby Maya.
This whole community rallies around Maya and keeping this family together.
To the owner of the bookstore, I love her very much. I can no longer take care of her.
Someone will have to watch Maya over the weekend.
Well, it's only for the weekend. How hard can it be?
Something happens within the story where he has to come to Lambiasi for help, but then a friendship evolves.
I think it's a sweet dynamic. I feel like they both admire something in one another, that they are not themselves.
Why didn't you leave her at the police station?
It didn't seem right.
You're not thinking of keeping it, are you?
I have a little break in time where I'm not having to read as many scripts and I'm going back to work, and it's this perfect little nugget of time where I can just throw myself into a book. So I just started The Book Thief, and it's wonderful so far.
I don't read that often, but I've started reading a lot through audiobooks. It's helped me quite a bit because I find it hard to read sort of traditional books.
I love books about spirituality. Actually, Lucy and I connected when we were talking about The Untethered Soul, which was a very important book to me.
Just finished reading the book you recommended. This was spectacular.
Maybe next time you will listen to me when I tell you something's the best.
Well, sometimes books don't find us until the right time.
I think that this movie is about stories and escapism, and the heart of it is AJ and love and loss and life after loss. And my character in particular, she kind of just represents the light at the end of the tunnel for AJ.
Thought today would be more romantic.
Oh, it's very romantic.
Made in Hollywood.
Hey guys, thanks for checking out this video. We want to know, what would you have asked? Let us know in the comments below. And if you like this video, don't forget to hit the like button. And as always, for more videos like this, hit the MIH TV logo right here. And for the next awesome video, click right there.